Hi everyone, how are you doing? It's been a couple of weeks since my last video as I've been pretty busy. I took my husband and our dogs on holiday to a lovely log cabin near King's Lynn, which is only around an hour and a bit north from where we live, but I felt we really needed the change of scenery to break up our routine, as we haven't been on holiday since the first lockdown last year. The cabin was perfect for a short self-catering holiday as it was a half hour from the coast, and there was a really beautiful wood just 5 minutes up the road from the cabin site. The dogs behaved themselves really well, as usual, after they settled in, and it was a lovely relaxing week away. After getting home, I wanted to crack on with a piece of art, so this week I sketched up a piece for a commission for a friend named Karen, who I've mentioned previously. She runs a fundraising group for Greyhounds, and I previously did a piece which I donated to one of her charity auctions. The piece I'm working on now for her is a paid commission which will be used by the charity for greeting cards to raise funds to support Greyhounds. The dog it features is one of Karen's own hounds named Sunny. She says his disposition matched his name, and when we looked through the photos she selected as potential candidates for the piece to be based upon, one photo stood out among the rest because of the wonderful smile on his face. I'm using some other photos Karen supplied to reference things that were not easily visible in the initial photo due to the lighting, such as the freckles on his nose and the colour of his eyes. When I started working on the piece, the first thing I did this time was to get it to a point where most of the underlying pencil work was represented with ink, even if it was only to an initial light pastel level, so that I knew all the underpinnings were there, as I felt the sketch was quite strong and wanted to make sure the ink matched the good structure that was present. I've then started to get base colours onto the foliage so that I can bring everything up to a similar level at the same time. You'll notice that the video skips from just the dog's nose and some of the white being done to most of the face and some flowers being painted. This is because I wasn't back in the habit of keeping my light and camera batteries charged after being away, so unfortunately I wasn't able to capture that portion of the process. However, there is still quite a lot of work to do on the dog itself, so that will probably be in one of the next videos. The flowers in this piece are African daisies, with some being the most common type of osteospermum, and the one in the lower left being Gazania, which has a bit of a larger flower with slightly more vibrant patterns. I was really pleased that Karen asked for these flowers, as I've always liked them, and they have a fairly straightforward structure that I was sure that I could do well. I'm not certain what plant the foliage at the top is from, as it was picked mainly for the leaf shape and tone, and I found it while looking on a royalty-free picture site, and like the fact that it has roughly heart-shaped, lobed leaves. I'm hoping to continue this painting next week, so I'm sure there will be a part 2 video coming soon. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe and hit the notification bell, as it helps me out a lot. As ever, if you have any comments or suggestions about things you'd like to see me cover, I'd love to hear them, so please leave me a comment. Thanks for watching and see you next time.
Thank you. Good morning. She's waiting for love.